Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School is dedicated to the formation of tomorrow's leaders through a Roman Catholic experience that provides excellence in atmosphere, academics, the arts, and athletics. Our vision is to be one of the most innovative, influential, and accomplished Roman Catholic schools in the nation.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Lord God, we praise your name, we give you thanks. Thank you for the gift of life, and thank you for the gift of family. We pray especially for each and every one of you who are here today. May the Lord guide you in your discernment as you look for a good school for your kids, for children. May the Lord bless our school, our faculty, and our staff. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Hello, future Mavericks. Thank you for joining us. I'm Irene Benitez, Director of Admissions. And on behalf of our administration, faculty, and staff, I'm honored to welcome you to our virtual open house. Throughout this presentation, you will experience our school's innovative Catholic identity as we introduce an outstanding academic program and a safe atmosphere where all students, whether passionate in the arts, extracurricular activities, or athletics, can flourish as they are prepared to be the leaders of tomorrow. Throughout the virtual tour, be sure to write down any questions you may have, as we will be available to answer them in one of our Zoom Live general sessions throughout the coming week. The link below will be live after this 10 a.m. virtual session and remain open until this Sunday, November 8th at noon. Don't worry, there will be additional sessions available after the Thanksgiving holiday. The link to register for the entrance exam and the application to apply is also available. Click here and it will take you to where you can create your account. It is recommended that you take the exam at the school of your first choice. Open house is one of our favorite days of the year, where we get to show off and let our future Mavericks witness the vision of our principal, Mr. Richard Jean, and how Archbishop McCarthy is an exemplary model of a Catholic college preparatory high school, a school where Catholic tradition meets innovation. Mr. Jean's leadership and implementation of technology have made our school a groundbreaker in the Archdiocese of Miami, and a school where educational leaders from across the country visit to learn and emulate what he has built. He has presented at international conferences and educational institutions across the globe, from Costa Rica and the Netherlands to Egypt and China, on topics such as transforming education and effective schools of the 21st century. Most recently, he was invited to London at the British Educational Training and Technology Show that was attended by over 113 countries. Mr. Jean has been named Principal of the Year by the National Catholic Education Association, and under his leadership, Archbishop McCarthy has been nationally recognized as a school of excellence in the U.S. by the Catholic Education Honor Roll, an Apple Distinguished School for the last 8 years, and as a recipient of the Innovations in Catholic Education Award.
Wow, it's easy to get accolades when you are a principal of a school of such great students, teachers, faculty, staff. It's really easy. And today I want to welcome you to our first virtual open house. This is my 11th, but never done a virtual one. But this is the world that we have been living in, McCarthy, for the last 11 years in transitioning. So today you get to see all the great things that we do with technology, Catholic education, and the four pillars that we are very proud of is the atmosphere, academics, activities, and athletics. And we're gonna go through a journey today and show you what we're about. Atmosphere is by far the most important of our four pillars. Why? Because we are a Catholic school. And the most important thing we want to teach our students is that God loves them. And to make sure that they, in the 4 years they're here, become better Christians. That is what we are here to make sure. That in 4 years, they learn about God, have a relationship with God, and become better human beings. Our campus ministry is run by our students, and it's student-led. And they are so excited to be involved and be able to do retreats.
The Transfiguration Retreat is a time to step back and enjoy the people around us. It's a time to strengthen our bonds with ourselves, our family, and most of all, God. We take great pride in our campus ministry program. And here at McCarthy, the students create the program. They create the retreats, and they pay it forward to the class under them. And we have generations and generations of Transfiguration and retreat leaders that still have this close bond to this day.
After the retreats and everything, you come back and you're just one big family, and allows you to just create a connection that through God, we are all one.
I talked about the spiritual part of atmosphere, but also there's a physical part of atmosphere. If the child doesn't feel safe in school, and I will discuss in two ways. The first is what we're dealing with now. We have a pandemic. As a school, we had to sit down and look at ourselves and say, okay, how can we do things differently to make sure that we're making sure the kids are safe? So we spend a lot of time having to look at everything that we do. And we're gonna show you a video of all the things that we did to make sure that our students are safe.
Hello everyone, my name is Tony Massaro. I'm the Executive Director of Advancement Operations here at Archbishop McCarthy High School, and I would like to welcome you to this portion of the tour, which we call the McCarthy Hygienically Clean Program. Archbishop McCarthy's ongoing commitment to offer an excellent Catholic high school education in a safe and secure environment will continue to be done during this COVID-19 pandemic. Our program, using the guidelines set by the CDC and for the Department of Education for the safe reopening of schools, as well as forming a valuable relationship with the Cleveland Clinic at Weston, have helped us form this program that you're about to view.
Prior to the start of each school day, our Hygienically Clean program begins. All Maverick family members must go online to answer our COVID-19 health screening questions. Upon entering the school, as you can see, we have signage reminding us, all of us, of what we must do. For example, you can see everyone before entering must wear a mask. This is following CDC protocol. Also, you walk through a thermal scanner, which takes body temperature. We have four other entrances other than the main entrance. Southeast side of the school, breezeway leading into the east 100 wing, west 100 wing, as well as the fitness center. We have modified our front foyer area. We have separated student services from our medical clinic. This is to keep everyone safe. As you walk into the medical clinic, your body temperature will be taken by a state certified paramedic. We have isolation rooms for those who may be experiencing COVID-19 symptoms. In between an isolation room for privacy, we have frosted glass. Also in this area, we have an office for Mr. Mike Sika, our paramedic, as well as a second area for those who may be experiencing non-COVID symptoms or may be injured. Each office, main office, advancement, etc., have plexiglass barriers to keep not only our employees safe, but also our student body. Restrooms have been equipped with necessary signage as well as touchless faucets, toilets, soap, and paper towel dispensers for everyone's safety. Touchless hand sanitizers have been strategically placed throughout the school. The hygienically clean crew keeps these filled on a regular basis. Signage has been placed throughout the school, directional signs in the stairwells as well as the hallways, so student traffic flow can be social distance. Water fountains have been turned off and covered by these red caps. Any student needing water can fill up a bottle in our touchless water dispensers located periodically throughout the school. Social distancing is being used in the classrooms. We put down where areas that students cannot sit. We put tape down that says do not use. Our teachers and students work together in sterilizing the desks and chairs. In all classrooms, we have plexiglass barriers on teachers' desks, protecting both students and teachers as well. Sanitizing occurs on a regular basis. We use BioPlanet product called Vital Oxide. All high use areas are sprayed on a daily basis, and the entire school is sprayed each weekend. In our student center, social distance, as you can see, is also being practiced. Not only waiting in line for the food, but as well as where each student sits. We not only use the student center for lunch, but also the gym. Each student, prior to the start of the day, can also go online and order their food using Neutral Slice app. Also, you can see that we have barriers between the students and the food, again, to protect themselves as well.
I'd like to thank you for taking the time for reviewing this portion of the tour, and please enjoy the rest. Thank you so much.
As I mentioned earlier, there's two parts of atmosphere when we talk about physical. The first one has now become front and center because this is what we're living in every day. But there's one that has kind of been pushed in the background, which is still, I think, very, very important, is making sure that our kids are physically safe in a sense of bullying, school shootings. We have set up a system to make sure that these things could be dealt with very effectively. We have a program called Red Shirts. You will learn more about the Red Shirt program. We have 180 cameras on our campus. Where do bullying happen? Not in the classroom. It's in the hallway, in the cafeteria, in the gym. We have cameras. We tell our students, something happened, you make sure you go to administrator. We're able to clip it, and we bring the parent in and say, this is not acceptable. Your child needs to find a new school, because we would not allow another child to put their hand on somebody else. So for us, this is still something that we look and is centered. We have an office where those 180 cameras are being watched by our security team.
Hi, my name is Bill Nessel. I'm Director of Security here at Archbishop McCarthy High School. I've been on campus 10 years. I'd like to take a moment to discuss the function of security here on campus. Security here at Archbishop McCarthy High School encompasses many areas. We have approximately 200 cameras on campus, inside the building and outside the campus grounds. The cameras are monitored in the security office, can also be viewed from iPads of certain personnel in administration and all in security. Our security team manages the door access system. The IDs for students, faculty, staff, administration, and visitors are tailored to their specific needs. For example, students can only access the exterior doors of the buildings from 7:30 until 3 p.m.
But access to classrooms is only during classroom hours, which is 7:56 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. Now I want to talk about our Red Shirt program. We have parent volunteers from numerous law enforcement agencies. Some are from the many police departments in the Broward and Dade counties. Each volunteer is a proud parent of Archbishop McCarthy Maverick. You will see them during arrival in the morning, dismissal in the afternoon, at sporting events, school events, both on and off the campus, to include the prom and homecoming dance.
My name's Luis Diaz. I'm the Chief of Police for the Hialeah Gardens Police Department. I volunteer as a Red Shirt here at Archbishop McCarthy. I have a child that attends here. Obviously, we, all the Red Shirts, we have a vested interest in the security of the school and the children in the school, the visitors, the parents, the teachers, the staff here. Mostly what I do is I usually work, volunteer in the evenings, sporting events, and also making sure that the children keep social distancing nowadays, wear their masks, and everybody's well behaved.
Good evening. My name is Tony Aguas, and I work as a police officer in the city of Miramar, Florida. I work as one of their SWAT officers and in the training unit. More importantly, I'm a proud parent here at Archbishop McCarthy High School, where I serve as one of the Red Shirts in their Red Shirt program. I have two daughters that attended McCarthy. My oldest daughter graduated 2 years ago, Alexandra, and my youngest daughter, Victoria, is a senior this year. Security was one of the primary reasons that my wife and I chose McCarthy for our girls. It's paramount along with education. They recently installed new locks for the school. Their camera system is second to none and an envy to many institutions. And as I mentioned before, it was one of the primary reasons that my wife and I chose McCarthy.
Hello, my name is Samantha Machado. I'm a sergeant with Miami-Dade Police Department. Most importantly, I'm a parent, and as you can see, I also work as a Red Shirt volunteer with the with Archbishop. My son is a first year student here in ninth grade, and we absolutely love the school so far. And I can tell you that I love being a part of this Red Shirt program. It has allowed me to be a part of the community here at the school.
Hello, my name is Jay Bernardo. I'm a member of the Red Shirt program here at Archbishop McCarthy. I have a federal law enforcement background, which is one of the prerequisites to be part of the volunteers here. I have also have two students. Two of my children go here, Archbishop currently. Today, one of my duties during my shift was to assist with social distancing during lunch hour.
I want to thank you for watching the security section of Open House. Just remember, our goal is a safe and secure environment for our students, faculty, staff, and visitors.
After atmosphere is academics. McCarthy is known for our academics. And it's always amazing when people say to me that your school is known for academics, but I thought everybody should be known for academics, because that is, I think, after the atmosphere is academics. Yes, we are a tough institution when it comes to academics. We want our kids to be challenged because we're here to prepare for college. And the people that we have preparing us with are just incredible. The teachers that we have here are highly qualified, compassionate, loving. They are the best group of educators I've ever worked with in my whole 25 years of being an educator. I have a video I want to show you, just to show you how impressive our kids are. So before you see the video, I got to explain something to you. Because a perfect score in the SAT is 1600. So remember that. Also, a perfect score in the ACT is 36. Okay? When you watch the video, you have to remember that. Now, we have, I believe, one of the best test prep program in the country. Ray Doss Test Prep. He has helped our school become, this year, we are the number one national merit students in the Archdiocese of Miami. And I believe we're definitely in the top five in the state of Florida of the amount of national merits. And we are so proud of these students, because pretty much you have to have a perfect score to become a national merit.
Ian Quelli, Our Lady of the Lakes Middle School, SAT 1560.
Julian Lopez, St. Mark Catholic School, SAT 1510.
Christopher Mustin, Parkway Christian, ACT 33.
Nicole Lambert, St. Bonaventure, SAT 1540. Jason Jaquith, Pembroke Pines Charter Middle School, ACT 35.
Adriana Garcia, Miami Lakes K-8 Center, 1520 SAT.
David Del Valle, Silver Trail Middle School, SAT 1500.
Manuel Noel, Sagemont School, ACT 34.
Callie Hinesley, Tequesta Trace Middle School, SAT 1530.
Tamara Andrea Mateo, Imagine Charter at Weston, ACT 34.
Mateo Rodriguez, Apalachee Montessori, SAT 1540.
Vikram Chari, Pembroke Pines Charter Middle School, 1460 SAT.
Shannon Sykes, Franklin Academy Middle School, SAT 1510.
Dale Zahn Townsend, The Blake School, SAT 1510.
Lauren DeVerona, St. Mark, SAT 1510.
Hello and welcome to academics at Archbishop McCarthy High School. I am Dr. Elsa Torres, Director of Academics and Curriculum. I have been in education for more than 40 years, 20 of them at Archbishop McCarthy High School. As a college preparatory high school, our primary task is to maximize your child's academic potential. Our curriculum includes advanced placement, college dual enrollment, honors, and college preparatory courses.
Hello, I'm Patrick Sando. I'm an academic coordinator here at Archbishop McCarthy High School. I'm proud to say that I've been in Catholic education for 24 years and a teacher here at McCarthy for 21. One of the best measures of any successful academic program is student performance on national standardized tests. Over the years, Archbishop McCarthy has grown accustomed to excellent results on these tests. And last year's graduates were no exception, as they continued to outperform their peers across the nation, both on the SAT and ACT exams.
Hello, my name is Lourdes Moss, and I am one of the academic coordinators. One of my roles is to provide academic support to your students throughout their 4 years at McCarthy. In conjunction with their guidance department and you, the parents, we form a team to ensure your child's academic success. The Excelsior Scholars Program is designed for incoming ninth grade students that have scored in the top 10% of the HSBT, the high school entrance exam, have exceptional grades in their middle school, and have scored above 90% in math and English standardized tests. These students are exposed to different educational experiences and to a rigorous academic program. Students begin with honors courses, dual enrollment level courses, and AP classes. Once selected into this program, they will be taking their first AP class in the ninth grade. In addition, these students receive complimentary Saturday PSAT and SAT preparation classes with Mr. Ray Doss. The fruits of their labor is evidenced by our 2020 National Merit Scholars. This year, we are proud to announce that we have the most merit scholars in the Archdiocese of Miami.
Hello, my name is Adriana Margatio, and I'm the director of the Guidance and Counseling Department at Archbishop McCarthy High School. The services we provide our students and families are academic, personal, and career counseling, in-house testing, and informational parent presentations.
Hello, my name is Dr. Christine Mastandrea, and this is my sixth year at Archbishop McCarthy. This year I have the senior class as their counselor, and next year I will be the freshman counselor. I'm also the Excelsior coordinator at our school, along with the varsity women's assistant soccer coach. Also a very proud Maverick, having graduated from here in 2008.
Hi, my name is Nicoletta Huck, and I'm currently the counselor of the current junior class, class of 2022. I am also the school's testing coordinator, work with the students on their PSAT, Aspire, ACT, and SAT tests, and scheduling all of those here at our school campus. I'm also the proud parent of a recent graduate of the class of 2020, and I've been working here at our school for about a decade.
Hi, my name is Ms. Quinones. I am the class of 2024 guidance counselor. I also oversee the transfer students. I am the career zone coordinator, and I'm also the in-house co-coordinator for our testing.
Hello, my name is Barry Jones. I am a special
programs coordinator. I work with students, teachers, and my fellow counselors, helping the students reach their full potential.
Hello, future Mavericks. My name is Terry Tribble, and I am the Director of College Advisement. My team consists of myself and two college advisors, Ms. Williams and Mr. Broska. Our mission is to provide your students with an overview and hands-on assistance with the college application process. We are a comprehensive office set up to meet all of your students' college needs and to assist them in any way possible to help them get into their dream schools. We are proud to boast that we have students admitted into the top universities in the country, as well as the most prestigious military academies every year. Check out the list of schools in the academic profile. The college office and your dream school awaits you. Now, let's hear what Alex has to say about the college office. Thank you for coming, enjoy the video, and enjoy the rest of the tour.
The College Advisement Office is a place where the college application process is made easy. Offering one-on-one meetings with advisors whenever needed, lab time where students are invited to work on applications during free time, and even group workshops with students and parents. The College Advisement Team makes your college application a team effort. What I love most about the college advisors is that they truly make the big step from high school to university exciting and stress-free.
The other part that we are known for is our technology. 11 years ago, we started this journey. I remember we were one of the first schools in the country that started an iPad program. And people thought, oh, wow, we're just doing it just for the sake of having, you know, an iPad in a classroom. No, it's not. You know, there's this picture here. And some of you old enough to remember all these devices. Remember the radio, the camcorder, the calculator, all these things is now in one device, the iPad. I think to myself, how better of a student would I have been when I was in school with all these things in one place? We've been 100% digital. All our textbooks is right here in the iPad. There's no excuses. My dog ate my homework. I couldn't send it in. No, everything's here. It makes students better. Why? Because they're more organized. Everything's at their fingertips. That is why we started this journey. And when everything happened, our transition was easy. All our kids have a device. Our kids already have Canvas, and we're gonna talk about that. All we did is just add Zoom, which was adding a link into their iPad. That was it. So for us, technology is how do we make our students better, more effective. That's how we use technology.
Hi, I'm Melissa Chrisweiser. This is my 18th year here at Archbishop McCarthy High School. I'm a math teacher, and along with my partner here, a tech mentor.
Hi, I'm Monica Arango. I've been at Archbishop for 16 years. I'm a science teacher, and as Melissa said, we are tech mentors, and our role is to inspire the use of technology throughout our school community.
We know there are a lot of schools with technology on their campus, but what we feel sets McCarthy apart is how well we infuse that technology into our students' day-to-day learning. The use of technology provides tools that enhance our school's organization and communication.
Being a one-to-one iPad school means those 20-pound book bags are now replaced with a single 1-pound device.
The addition of Canvas, our digital learning platform, means better organization for students and teachers. Students have access to Canvas courses for academics, extracurricular, and general student information. One of the advantages Canvas gives our students is a digital to-do list. This list includes homework, quizzes, tests, and even student activities information, which conveniently clears off the to-do list once students complete it. Each teacher's homepage includes their tutoring hours, testing days, and grade weights, along with a direct link to their email. Within Canvas, students can click into the assignment to see the details, including a rubric, and also submit the assignment. Good news, parents, you can also create an observer account to see everything your student sees on Canvas. With a click of a button, students and parents can see class averages. Click on the class and you'll get a detailed breakdown of the grades. Click on an individual grade and you'll see what the student submitted and the feedback provided by the teacher. Teacher collaboration is a critical component to our success. Teachers meet regularly to stay on the same track. Departmental tests cover the same content on the same day, which must be one of the department's assigned test days.
so that students don't have more than 3 tests in a day, and combining the best traits of each teacher, we have designed master courses.
To assure that both our teachers and students are comfortable using the technology, we have created faculty and student courses on Canvas that are packed with guides and video tutorials on how to use the apps and programs. We also spend a lot of time assisting our teachers on various ways to create innovative classroom environments. Recently, all our teachers went through several training sessions that ended with our faculty becoming Apple certified teachers. This empowers teachers, and now they are encouraging students to use technology to create dynamic presentations. Students are thinking outside of the box, they're becoming the leaders of the classroom, and they're demonstrating their creativity. One of the greatest things we hear from alumni is how much using Canvas has helped prepare them for college. Over 1,000 universities worldwide are using Canvas, and we're giving our students that advantage. Another component that sets us apart is our in-house support team. Together, we work to provide support not only for teachers and students, but also parents as well.
I'm Mary Albanese. I've been teaching the Archdiocese of Miami for 28 years, and I'm in my 9th year at Archbishop McCarthy. At Archbishop McCarthy, the array of technology tools we have been given have enabled us to better meet our students' needs. Our online textbooks allow audio learners to hear as well as read a story. Games and quizzes give teachers and students immediate feedback on what students have learned in a lesson and what they have not yet grasped. Teachers can display their textbooks on interactive display boards, enabling them to model in real time how to annotate challenging literary works. Using apps such as Keynote Live and Google Docs facilitates collaboration and peer review among students while allowing teachers to monitor students' work. We still read, analyze, and write about novels, short stories, plays, and poetry, but with the technology we have at our fingertips, we can do it better.
Hello, my name is Julie Deligny, and I am a theology teacher here at Archbishop McCarthy High School. Here in the theology department, we strive in student-centered pedagogy in which students are challenged to learn more about their faith by actively engaging in the subject and relating it to their everyday lives. We promote project-based learning because it is a teaching method in which students learn by actively engaging in real-world and personally meaningful projects. Students are given special tasks that they perform in groups to encourage collaboration, which offers more opportunity for critical thinking. Our student group work not only enhances communication within the classroom, but also aids in professional development skills.
My name is Stephen Hanrahan, and I am the Science Department Chair and Robotics Team Moderator at Archbishop McCarthy High School. I've been teaching for 28 years, the last 7 of which have been here at Archbishop McCarthy. At Archbishop McCarthy, I have access to all the latest technological tools to make what I do in the classroom so much more effective. For example, one of my favorite apps to use has been Nearpod. Nearpod allows me to get real-time feedback on student progress. No longer do I have to wait until test day to see how my students are doing. Nearpod allows me to tailor my lessons accordingly to the data I collect, so I can focus my teaching on those content areas that need extra attention. Additionally, Nearpod has allowed me to seamlessly transition from the traditional classroom setting to the current hybrid environment where students are working from both home and school. In addition to apps such as Nearpod, the science department has access to a multitude of apps and virtual labs to bring our science lessons to life. New technologies such as our microscopes with built-in Wi-Fi hotspots allow our students to work collaboratively using their iPads to easily capture and share video and images of what they are observing. I look forward to what new technological innovations await on the horizon.
Hi, my name is Jean Ferrier. I'm the Math Department Chair here at Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School. I've been teaching for 20 years and 18 years in Catholic education.
So one of the things that I love that we require in the math department is that each teacher records their daily lesson. Teachers post their videos daily to YouTube. Student feedback on videos has been absolutely tremendous. These videos give McCarthy students an opportunity to watch videos outside of a school setting. It allows students to rewatch a lesson that they had difficulty understanding. It gives students that miss class for drama or for athletics an opportunity to not fall too far behind. McCarthy students also have access to Math Academy. This is a platform where all math and science videos are posted daily, so all students have access to all teachers, not just their own.
Okay, this is our R.1 notes. We're going to review distance and midpoint.
At Archbishop McCarthy, we enhance our curriculum with project-based learning strategies. This type of instruction energizes student growth by capitalizing on authentic, cooperative, student-centered tasks, all aimed at fostering real-world skills in addition to deeper understanding. Of course, our integration of technology plays a vital role in this process, facilitating research, collaboration, critical thinking, and communication skills across our curriculum.
Hi, my name is Jan Marie Meadows. I've been teaching mathematics for 16 years, and this is my sixth year at Archbishop McCarthy High School. We also use an app called ClassKick that allows the teacher to monitor, assess, make corrections, and give feedback in real time. The students work on problems individually on their iPads, and I can see all their screens from one device, and it truly helps me be there for all of them.
Hello, my name is Marshall Ho. I'm a science teacher at Archbishop McCarthy. I have been in Catholic education for over 20 years, all here in this community. I teach anatomy and physiology honors and sports medicine for college dual enrollment. In the past 20 years, I have witnessed the evolution of education in the classroom. Being one of the first schools to implement the one-to-one iPad program has truly enhanced student learning. However, students continue learning hands-on as well as using technology to investigate the sciences. In my anatomy honors classes, students can use applications to dissect any body system, both virtually or continue to do so with a hands-on guided approach.
Athletics. I hear sometimes there's a rumor that I don't like sports. I don't support sports, and that's not true. One thing, I don't believe in scholarship for athletes. I don't believe that a child should just be able to come to a Catholic school for free because they're a good football player, basketball player. I don't agree with that. I think if a child qualifies and needs help to be able to be at a Catholic school, we should. That is our mission as a Catholic school, but not just to win games. We're okay, I'm okay, to lose or win with our students. We're not gonna stack the deck with people just because they come to our school for athletics. 2 years ago, I self-reported us. We had a parent that had students at our school, and we self-reported because it shouldn't happen. Do we support? Yes, we do. Sports is a great way, leadership. Learning how to commit yourself, learn how to win and lose, that's important. And I think that's experience that every child should have. Now, do kids get cut? Yes. Are we competitive? 100% with our students here. And you're gonna see and you're gonna hear all the great things that our teams are doing.
Hi, my name is Byron Walker, Athletic Director at Archbishop McCarthy High School. Welcome to our open house. Here at Archbishop McCarthy, we're committed to our student athletes and will do our best to develop their skills both in and out of the classroom. Maverick teams have a rich history of excellence on and off the playing field. One of the primary goals of our athletic program is to accentuate the development of the whole student and help them achieve a personal level of excellence in the areas of academics, fitness, teamwork, commitment, respect for others, and sportsmanship. Currently, we field 33 varsity teams, 19 junior varsity, 2 freshmen, and 2 club teams. Over the past 22 years, our varsity teams have won 96 district team titles, 36 regional team titles, 12 state championships, 7 in baseball, 3 in women's golf, 1 in men's volleyball, and 1 in women's soccer. 17 state runner-up and 10 individual state championships. At the national level, our baseball team has won 2 national titles. 1 FCDA national championship has been won in dance and 2 individual national championships in wrestling. Throughout our school's history, the varsity sports program has maintained a winning percentage of close to 70%. In 2017 and 2018, our winter and spring teams, and in 2018-2019, our fall, winter, and spring teams were named FHSAA overall 6A team academic champions. Overall, our varsity teams averaged an unweighted grade point average of 3.0 or higher. Individually, over the last 22 years, 230 of our athletes have earned first-team all-county honors in a variety of sports by the local media, and 255 have signed college scholarships to continue both their academic and athletic careers. As well as our athletic and academic accomplishments, we take pride in our athletic facilities. Here at McCarthy, we continue to improve them, with our next addition being synthetic turf for all of our stadium fields. Thank you for joining us, and we hope you enjoy your tour.
Arts and activity, I believe, is the glue of a school to make sure the kids are happy, because the classroom is not where they should be having interactions and having fun. Where they build relationships and find their interests is the arts, the activities. That's where they're able to meet kids that are like-minded, have friendships, be able to do things after school, to be involved. That is what keeps students in the school, because that is where they create friendships, they get to be involved, they get to have that patience. So no matter what school you decide to go to, make sure to encourage that your child is involved in some activity, something in the arts, because that's where they grow.
Hi, my name is Michelle Lovett. I'm the Student Activities Director here at Archbishop McCarthy High School. I've been working in the Archdiocese of Miami for over 20 years, 14 as a teacher and 6 as an administrator. Each day here at McCarthy, our team of professionals gets to guide our students as they create maverick memories in the areas they choose to develop their specific talents. They do this through fine arts courses and clubs and activities. The activities we have on campus are our National Honor Societies, campus ministries, community involvement clubs, special interest clubs, art and media groups, professional development clubs, and also our leadership and student government. We also have competitive teams such as National Speech and Debate, Model UN, TV production, and the International Thespian Society. Throughout our campus, you will find talented creators working together to prepare for that next event. We have the Maverick Black Box Theater, filled with actors reciting lines for their next show, the Maverick Sound Marching Band tuning their instruments, the drumline creating beats, the liturgical choir singing melodies, the Spanish Music Club strumming their guitar and singing along. Then we have our artistic creators working hard in Ms. Hansen's art studio. We have Ms. Santilli guiding our digital artists. We are also surrounded by the yearbook photographers capturing moments for us to treasure for the years to come. And let's not forget about our creative energy in our Mav News TV production studio.
And our award-winning robotics team.
Here at Archbishop McCarthy High School, we participate in the Global VEX Robotics Competition. VEX Robotics is the largest competitive robotics platform in the world, with 25,000 teams and over 1 million students participating from around the globe. For the last several years, our Maverick Robotics team has been the most dominant team in the state of Florida. We have won 5 state championships, including the last 3 championships in a row. We have competed on a national level and have been invited to the World Championship 6 different times. Additionally, for the last several years, we have fielded the largest team in the state, with 7 different robots and 35 team members. So if you're interested in having the opportunity to compete at the highest levels of robotics, you need look no further than Archbishop McCarthy.
Here at Archbishop McCarthy, the arts surround us, fill us up, and entertain us each day on campus. We are fortunate to be surrounded by such talent. Now I'd like to move into something I call the art of being a Maverick. The art of being a Maverick is something that I've been blessed to see happen for the past 10 years here at McCarthy. When students use their talents and abilities to create moments and memories, our students create these masterpieces throughout their 4 years, and they will never forget these moments. Over the 4 years at McCarthy, our students learn how to give. They learn how to grow into giving their time, talent, or treasure to others through their hard work in these various clubs and societies. They also work together to make school-wide fundraisers. In learning how to give, they will learn that it spreads so much joy and hope for those who receive the gift, as well as for their heart and soul. In participating in all the extracurricular clubs and events, along with our faith-filled education, our students receive the formation to become tomorrow's leaders.
Thank you for joining us in our virtual open house. I know it's been long, but before I end, I'd like to show you something. You see this picture? 1950. We still have schools like this. No devices, teachers lecturing for 45 minutes, and people wonder why kids are not engaged and bored. Could you have seen us doing this whole presentation with just this? We know that kids are visual learners. Sometimes in my presentation, I did not say anything. I didn't have to tell you how long I've been a principal. It was up there. You got to see it. This is how we teach at McCarthy. We use technology to get the kids to be engaged. So again, thank you for taking your time to be with us. And hopefully, I'll be seeing you next year.